Hello and welcome to my new video. Today I will be giving you the ultimate b-hop tutorial with all the best b-hop macros existing right now. I will also explain how to install and use them in the best way. So if you want to bunny hop like a pro, then this is definitely the video for you. To be able to use the download file, you need to have Razer Synapse 2.0, which requires a Razer mouse or keyboard. If you don't, then using the same timings should in theory work for any other macro software. How to download? Follow the link in the description to mediafire.com. Here you can download the b-hop macros by pressing the download button. Now, save the macro somewhere safe on your PC, where you can find it later. A quick reminder. There will be lots of information in the description, so go and check it out before asking questions. Now it is time to open Razer Synapse. Go to Macros and click the triple dot icon and select Import. Now browse and locate the file you downloaded. It should be bhop macro_v2.razersynapse and click Import again. Now you should have three different type of macros available under the Macro tab. These macros are called bhop_17ms, which spams spacebar with 70 millisecond delay to make you hit a somewhat decent bhop at any surface and tick rate. The next one is bhop_64tick_v1. It is the same as the old macro from the bhop video I made that presses space with a specific delay to hit a perfect bunny hop at 100% flat surface on 64 tick servers. At last we have V2. It is the same as V1, but improved so it does not have an extra b-hop at the end. I will go into more detail on how they work and which one you should use later in the video. Now go back to mouse and first make a new profile and give it a name that fits. So you can easily switch between profiles if you want to disable the b-hop macro. Then change the options in the performance menu to what you prefer. I use 800 dpi and 1000 Hz in polling rate. Now go back to your customize settings, and here you can choose what button you want to assign the macros to, and select macro as the key assignment. Now select the bhop macro you want to use, and do not forget to put the playback options as play while assigned key is pressed for all bhop macros. If you are using a Razer mouse, I highly recommend assigning it to one of your mouse buttons, 4 or 5. If you're using a keyboard, you can assign it to any button you feel comfortable pressing and doesn't interfere with your gameplay. Also, do not assign the macro to space or the macro won't work. And now we are done installing the bhop macro. You can easily change between profiles and go back to the original one if you want to disable the bhop macro without removing the assignments, by selecting the profile tab in Razer Synapse or by clicking the item on your desktop. Now let's start CSGO. Before you start bhopping, go into your options menu to mouse and keyboard and make sure you have jump bind to space. Optional. If you want to jump with the scroll wheel, you can put these two commands into the console to jump with both spacebar and the mouse wheel. Now if you want to practice b-hopping with the macros, start your own local server. Here are two helpful commands you can use to make it easier to learn. net_graph1, which will show you the tick rate of the server and your FPS and more. And cl_show+1, which will show you your current speed and velocity in the game in the top left corner. So how do you use the bhop macro? First, you need to make sure you have done everything correctly, and you should stand still at the place and press and hold down the button you assign the macro to. If you are now jumping up and down as soon as you hit the ground like this, you have installed it correctly. To use the macro in motion, I recommend reaching full speed with your weapon, then hold down the macro button again for as long as you want to b-hop. As you can see, you will keep the speed you had before the previous jump. Now let's add strafing. This is what makes you gain more speed than normal, which is 200 units per second, and you can reach a speed up to 300 UPS. When you reach a greater speed than 300 UPS, the server will automatically slow you down to about 200 UPS. Pro tip! To avoid this, try to stay under 300 UPS by not strafing too much when you are close to 300 UPS. Congratulations, you are now able to bunny hop like a pro. Now let's talk about the different B-hop macros and which one you should use. V1 is the same macro as the old B-hop tutorial, which also had a problem with it that it makes an extra hop at the end, which can be really annoying. But with practice you can work around it and prepare for this extra hop. Most importantly, this macro is the most consistent of all of them, from my experience, and I recommend this to players that have a bit of experience about B-hopping and know how to strafe. V2, same as V1, but with no extra hop at the end. But it's a bit less consistent to hit the first B-hop for some reason compared to V1. Recommended to those who already have tested the old macro and want to upgrade. Both of these versions only work on 100% flat surfaces and 64 tick servers, but it is the best way to bunny hop on flat ground. So you can easily gain lots of speed and keep it, which is the whole point of B-hopping after all. The 17 millisecond macro is a B-hop macro that works on any surface and also on 128 tick servers, but it is by far the least consistent and it doesn't always hit a perfect B-hop, so it will be more difficult to keep your speed above 250 UPS compared to the other macros. I recommend this to the more casual players that just want to B-hop for fun and not to gain a speed advantage. The ultimate solution is to have both V1 or 2 with the 17 millisecond macro assigned to a button each. In this case, you can use the best B-hop macro depending on the situation. Alright, so let's have a little FAQ. Can you get Vac Banned for using macros? No, macros only makes you pre-see press buttons on your keyboard, and this is nothing that Vac can detect or get you banned for. Can you get Overwatch Banned? Yes. You could get Overwatch Banned for using B-hop macros, but the risk is very low because you're still able to do B-hops like this. The macro only makes it more consistent for you. Does it work for other gaming mouses or keyboards? No, you will need the Razer Synapse software, which can only be used by having a Razer mouse or keyboard. In theory, it should work with the same delay with other macro softwares. My macro says space instead of Blanksteg as yours, what is wrong? Nothing is wrong. Blanksteg is space in Swedish, since I have a Swedish keyboard, so there's nothing wrong with your macro. Does it work for other operating systems as well? Mac and Linux? Well, what I know so far is that many people have problems with Mac, and it doesn't seem to work. And for Linux, I think it is the same. But the 17 millisecond delay macro should still work. For more questions, please read my FAQ that I will be linking in the description. Do you need extra help with the B-hop macros? Well, I suggest that you join my Steam group, where we can help each other as a community, and it will be linked in the video description. But that's all for now, and don't forget to have fun!